Hi everybody. So today we're going to be practicing two seated poses. The first pose you read about in the Yoga Journal article, Janushirasana, which is Sanskrit for head to knee forward bend. And as we're practicing today, I want to invite all of you to imagine that you're breathing into your heart center, located right behind our breastbone, very close to our heart, is our thymus gland. And the thymus gland is responsible for the production of T cells, which help in the protection of our body against viruses and bacteria. So it's really important in our immune function. So as we're practicing today, just imagine that your breath is moving into your heart, and you're breathing in new opportunities, and as you exhale, you're letting go of what doesn't serve you. So try that, see if it works for you. And let's move into Janushirasana now, which I just want to mention is really, really grounding. It is an excellent pose for helping with mild anxiety or depression, digestive issues. If you have any trouble sleeping, it can be very helpful to just let your body feel safe and move into a grounding space. This also stretches our hamstrings, stretches our spines, and if you're like me, I often have tight hamstrings from running, and walking might also shorten our hamstrings. So this is a pose that actively lengthens those hamstrings. So let's bring one foot, your left foot, into the side of your right thigh. So just pressing firmly there. And your back is long, tall, and strong. Shoulders are up and rolled back. There's plenty of space from your ear to your shoulders. And as we breathe in, we're slightly twisting our spine, and we'll exhale, walking our hands forward. Now, this might be as far as some of us are able to get if our hamstrings are especially tight. So this is why I want to invite all of you to pause it now if you need to get a towel. Most of us have towels, right? This is a dish towel. And you can actually wrap that around your foot and just hold it here, and you might feel a very deep stretch. If your spine is tall and strong, this might be as far as you're able to get, and that's okay. This can help lengthen and reintegrate those hamstring muscles while also strengthening our spine. So when you breathe in, your spine is getting longer, and as you breathe out, you may be able to move into this pose a little bit more deeply. And just imagine now that you're filling your heart space as you breathe in, and just letting go of what doesn't serve you as you breathe out. Maybe you remove the towel if you feel like you're a little bit more secure and more warmed up into this pose. So let's stay here for three more breaths. You can close your eyes if you'd like. And on an inhale, come back up to center. And let's bring both legs out in front of us. You might move them up and down a bit. And now we will bring our left foot inside of the right thigh and have that towel handy if that served you last time. So breathe in, filling up that heart space, and exhale, slowly walk your hands forward. Maybe you grab that towel if your hamstrings are especially tight. But make sure there's plenty of room between your shoulders and your ears so you're not hunching. Breathe in, spine lengthens. Exhale as you move more deeply into the pose. Maybe you don't need the towel anymore. If you do, that's okay too. Breathe in, spine lengthens. Breathe out as you move more deeply into this pose. And stay here for three more breaths, and you're always welcome to close your eyes. Breathe in, coming back up to center with a tall, strong spine. Now bring your legs out in front of your feet out in front of you so they're hip width apart, and maybe place your hands behind your hips and just let your knees fall first to one side then the other, just to kind of shake out those hips. Rinse them out from that Janu Shirsasana. So the last pose we'll practice today for our seated poses is wide angle seated forward bend. So let's bring our legs out in front of us at a 90 degree angle. Make sure you can see my feet. So our toes are flexed to protect our knees. Our knees are pointing forward toward the sky. And you might want to have a stack of pillows or blankets handy if you are feeling in need of a more restorative pose today. This is also another grounding pose. This is a great tool before bed. It can help you just refocus in the middle of the day as well. So we'll be breathing in to lengthen our spine. And as we exhale, we'll hinge forward from our hips. You might even want to put your hands in this little C formation at your hips, just so you can really assure that you're moving forward from your hips. So let's start from the top. Breathe in, lengthen your spine, and then breathe out as you hinge forward. And your feet are flexed. And now maybe you'll walk your hands a little bit forward. We want to keep our spine long and strong, just like in Janu Shirsasana. Plenty of space from our ears to our shoulders. Some of you may be very flexible and open in your hamstrings, so you'll be able to come to rest your head on the floor. But if that's not available to you, perhaps you take your two fists and you set them down in front of you and rest your forehead on your fist. Something that's a little bit more comfy than fists might be some pillows and blankets. So you may come to rest your head on that cozy little prop that you've built. So let's stay here folded for 10 breaths. And again, I want to invite all of you to imagine that you're filling up your heart space with every breath that you take. So again, as you inhale, your spine is growing long. And as you exhale, you may be able to move into the pose a little bit more deeply. Perhaps you even move a path. Take three more breaths. And then inhale, come back up, bring your feet in, and maybe we'll windshield wiper those hips again. All right, friends, you are welcome to stay in any of those poses for as long as is comfortable for you. Please feel free, as always, to reach out to me via email or on Canvas. Thank you so much, everyone, from my heart to yours.
Namaste.